Sushant, I always knew there was an overwhelming attendance, but I haven't felt it like this since morning.
Good morning, guys. Good morning. They can hear me, right?
I think they can hear you. He said good morning. I didn't hear you guys say good morning back.
Thank you so much, guys, for taking out time. Thank you so much for participating in such large numbers. And we just take it from here.
Yeah. All right. So, Sushant, the Behtar India campaign, you know, I want to start by talking about you and the Behtar India campaign. Because sure. When you talk about India, you think about the time when we didn't really think about cleanliness. We didn't think about hygiene and all of that. And now we've come a long way with all the movements that are happening, and particularly this one.
Sure.
And you've come a long way too. Yeah. You know, so in that context, how do you look at
cleaning
this?
Myself up? Yes, of course. I think it is the concerns that we are addressing are very, very important and immediate. Also because at this point of time, you're thinking, why are we the way we are, and we are addressing that. And then carefully taking out things that we need to work on.
Yeah.
And the most important thing, which I feel is very, very innovative, and thanks NDTV for it, I think it's a very good setup. I think it's a non-zero sum setup where individually you can use your skill and compete.
Yeah.
But at the same time, what you do is, as a team, the whole is much more than the sum of its parts.
Yeah.
So everybody is benefited. So yes, thanks to NDTV for that.
All right. Why I brought that up in the context of where we thought about hygiene and cleanliness,
yeah,
and of course now where we are in terms of the awareness that we've managed to create about Behtar India, is because, just to give you guys an example, I don't know how many of you know, but you were somebody who used to be dancing at the back of a troupe, and now you're a star.
I used to dance in my classrooms also.
Right.
And,
don't do that, guys.
And they would throw me out of the classroom. But then I thought, let's put it to good use. And I started while I was in my college here in Delhi.
Yeah.
I was in Delhi College of Engineering. And while I was expected to study, I was also doing theater and dancing behind all the possible stars. Yeah, as a background dancer.
Yeah. And then suddenly you were in front of the stars and they were giving you trophies.
Oh yes, that's actually what happened. I mean, like, I'm a big Shah Rukh fan. And I remember when I was in school, I went to Swadesh, the film that he did, on the set to get his autograph. I couldn't, unfortunately, get the autograph. But few years down the line, I was dancing behind him.
Yeah.
And he just turned back and he's like, am I doing it correctly? And I was like, yes, of course. And then few years later, he gave me my best debut.
Best
award.
Debut, huh?
Yes.
All right.
It's a good story. Thank you.
Okay, I'm sure a lot of kids here, they're all students, Sushant. They would like to know, how was Sushant Singh Rajput as a student, right? Were you academically brilliant, or were you a backbencher, or you were good in sports? I know you were a genius in physics.
And maths.
Oh.
That's
sorry, yeah.
Okay.
You said the sum of all the things and I lost.
These are two heavy words.
I feel guilty while saying that I was good in maths, because not many people like it.
Right.
So you were good in physics, I
very thought. Good, yeah. I was amazing.
What's Newton's second law?
I don't know what you're talking about.
No, come on. You have to say what's Newton's second law.
No idea. A zero idea. But I'll tell you, you were good in physics, and when you say that people are good in physics, you weren't just good, you won a national award, right?
Yes. Olympiad.
Yeah. The National Olympiad in Physics, you won.
Yeah.
Good speech.
Yeah.
But I feel this is something that I feel about education. If you make students learn by putting things in perspective, by putting things in context, then we like studying. And we don't have to mug up formulas, but we would remember all our lives because we understand why we are learning this.
Right.
Now what happens is, normally, and it's very unfortunate, the knowledge structure of education system has to do with, we still sort of just are trained to, you know, get the skill of taking tests, which is a very redundant skill, I guess.
Right.
And also I feel that the things that we are tested on, I mean, like how much we can remember, and in a stipulated time, how much we can come up with those things. I think these are also very redundant skills, because my mobile phone or a computer can
answer those questions.
Yeah, can be 100 times, 1,000 times better than that.
Yeah.
So I think we need to, first of all, address this issue and also change the differentiator actually giving ranks to students, I think the differentiator needs to change. Not on these set of skills, which are redundant, but come up with something completely new.
There's a lot of pressure on kids, you know, these cutoffs. And so you are somebody who actually chose to drop engineering out to pursue acting. There are a lot of students watching you. We don't recommend that at all. but you are super successful in what you're doing. What is the message out? You would like to ease off a little. What is the message out to students?
I think it's my personal opinion, and I might be wrong, but this is what I felt, that I was lied most of the times. I was told that, you know what, be number one, number two, and you'll get acknowledgement. You'll earn a lot of money, and that is success, and that will be the answer of all your problems. Let me tell you, these two things were very, very important differentiators in my life. I didn't have much money when I was growing up, and I was a shy kid, so any sort of acknowledgement would also mean a lot.
Yeah.
What I got to know was when I started having it, after a point, say, what do you call that, point of inflection or something? Yeah. So after that point, that I became so immune to it that it was not giving me any kick.
Okay.
And if I was doing something which I didn't like to do for these two things, imagine what would I do for next 20, 30 years. I don't like doing that. And even money and fame that people told me would be the differentiators, they have stopped giving me any kick.
Right.
So I think it's extremely important, very, very important. I just beg you guys to listen to me at this point of time. Just identify the thing that you actually like doing. If you can be successful in something that you don't like doing, and I think you'll be extremely successful in things that you actually like doing. And you end up having much more fame and much more money than you're actually planning to have at this point of time.
Okay, we've been planning something very special. Sushant, aap kaun se school mein padhe hain?
Main St. Keris mein padha hun aur Kulachi Hansraj mein padha hun aur Delhi College of Engineering mein padhna chahta tha aur teesre saal mein I dropped out.
So, DAV Kulachi.
Ji.
Neeta Arora, does that name ring a bell?
Oh yes, yes, of course. She was my teacher.
She was your maths teacher.
Yeah.
And Ms. Neeta Arora is here with us in the audience.
Very well.
Ma'am, please come on the stage. Just give her a hand.
I'm still scared.
मैम कैसा लग रहा है आपको आपके स्टूडेंट से मिलके? ओके ओके
अनीता अग्रवाल
गिव मी द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू स्कोल्ड हिम वंस अगेन
एग्जैक्टली द वे यू डिड
आई एम सो यूज्ड टू इट दैट आई कैन टेक वन मोर
एंड वाज ही एज गुड एज मैथ्स एज ही क्लेमिंग यू टॉट हिम मैथ्स राइट
या
वाज ही एज गुड एज मैथ्स
यस ही वाज वेरी गुड इन मैथ्स एंड very quick in answering.
See,
he was very good.
Okay.
And very shy also.
Okay.
Ma'am, but I had to encourage. A lot of that responsibility goes on you, na? Because of you, he was good in math.
Sure, yes, of course. Are
you? So, you have any childhood memory, ma'am, of Sushant? Kuch aisi yaad inke baare mein jo aapko inke schooli dinon se?
मैम मैं इसके बारे में एक चीज़ बताना चाहूँगा. 11th और 12th में मैम ने मुझे मैथ्स पढ़ाया और इस समय जो था मैं और बहुत सारी चीज़ें एक्सप्लोर कर रहा था.
अब आपको ये तो पता नहीं मैम क्या बोलेंगे, पहले ही फॉरवर्ड दे दूँ
तो और बैक बेंच पे मैं बैठता था
right.
और बहुत समय में मुझे बेंच में नहीं मिलती थी क्योंकि मुझे बाहर कर दिया जाता था क्योंकि मैं इतना शरारती था. लेकिन मैं मैथ्स में अच्छा था. मैथ्स में अच्छा था.
एक्चुअली क्या याद है इनकी जो आपको आपके पास है?
नो, ही यूज्ड टू आस्क गुड क्वेश्चंस whenever we are discussing mathematics, okay, and really witty,
which is a very, very important thing. Somebody told me that answering questions limits you. You should come up with better questions.
That was very good.
So that was good.
Without interaction, maths is not possible, and he was good at that.
Great.
Ma'am, was he a backbencher or a frontbencher?
No, he used to sit. He used to sit at the back, but I encouraged him.
Oh, so he used to sit at the back when he used to get
Yeah. So why not have a round of applause to this teacher and all the teachers who shape us so well. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you.
really liked it today to be proud of his teacher.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr.
Sorry.
तुम कौन से बेंच पे बैठते थे मेरा बताओ?
मैं बेंच पे नहीं बैठता था, मैं बाहर बैठता था. All right. You know, one question I wanted to ask you was that while you were interested in physics and math, did you ever think when you were growing up that there would be a competition for a better India about cleanliness and hygiene and the environment? Did you think that would ever happen?
To be very honest, I was more than anticipation. I was hoping that something like this should happen. And I'm extremely grateful to NDTV for coming up with such an innovative and such an extremely important initiative.
Yeah, okay. Your sister, and you have four siblings.
Yep,
it's interesting to note that. And while you guys have seen him in Dhoni and you've seen him play the helicopter shot, at the end of the day, he's somebody who's not a better batsman or cricketer than his sister, Meeta. Meetu.
She'll kill me if I...
Yeah, she'll kill me now, probably. And she was a state-level cricketer and a zonal-level cricketer. But when you were growing up with your siblings, you know, your best moments are usually with your siblings.
Sure.
At least for me, I have two. Was there ever a moment that they checked you for littering or checked you for hygiene or you checked them and there was a moment like that?
Oh, yes. I was a very naughty kid.
Yeah.
And also very pampered. And yeah, so they made sure that... By the time I was 13 or 14, they fixed me up completely.
They fixed you.
Yeah.
All right. आपको ठीक कर दिया already.
बिल्कुल. और अब देखो मुझे मैं कितना साफ सुथरा
रहता हूँ. बहुत ही ज़्यादा. मज़ा आ गया.
We have a lot of student audience here, Sushant, and a lot of them who have been performing brilliantly well in Behtar India. So we want to give those students a chance to ask Sushant a question of their choice. Can I have Trisha from Oak Ridge? Is she here? Trisha, do you have a question for Sushant?
She's there. You can stand up.
Yeah. Please stand up, introduce yourself, your school, and then your question.
I'm Trisha. I'm from Oak Ridge.
Hi, Trisha.
I'm in 8th grade.
The number one slot.
Okay. Wow. Congratulations.
Thank you. Can I come back to the end? I'll think of a question.
Oh, yeah, please.
Till then.
Please do that.
Yeah, you can come again.
Please do that. Okay, I have Shivali Mishra from Lotus Valley. Is she here? Shivali, hi.
Yeah, you guys can clap for her. Yeah, whoever wants to clap for her, clap for her. Where is she? Yeah.
Okay, so I just wanted to ask, like, have you ever been a part of any like campaign or any project related to environment or something like that?
Related to what?
Environment.
Related to environment, like Behtar India. Have you ever been a part of like a project or
well,
a campaign?
As I said, I was always hoping that something like this would come up with the first opportunity that I got associated with it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.